fire has all properties that are similar to that of knowledge. Fire ignites, just like the spark of knowledge in our minds. Fire is ever shifting, just like knowledge, as both of them can never be stagnant. Fire burns, just like the arrogance that comes with knowledge. And fire can never be contained. And if it is contained, just like knowledge, it will blaze when it is released.
Okay, Jenny, are your students comfortable and can they hear it properly?
Yes, can you hear? Yes, they can, yeah.
Do we have to go a bit slower than this, or you want us to go at the same pace?
Maybe a bit slower.
A bit slower. Okay,
yeah.
You want us to repeat, or should our next speaker go on with this folktale?
The next one can come.
The next person can come. And go a little slow, because they're younger.
Sages and rishis asked for help from Lord Vishnu to send the holy fire of knowledge. Lord Vishnu agreed and asked and diverted the request to Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma agreed but this was converted into a physical form known Padgani, the eternity of knowledge. This was known by an eternity of knowledge, and Lord Brahma summons Lord Goddess Saraswati to help. Goddess Saraswati agreed and took the form of river, because the river was the only form to help the rishis and munis and next, because the river was the only form fluid and can only contract with the form of fire. Goddess Saraswati was the only one who was the goddess of knowledge and agreed with this and turned in the form of knowledge.
Hello everybody, I'm Manya.
Say hi.
Hello.
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 So as my speaker said, the river Saraswati, or the goddess Saraswati, took the form of water in a form of a river and plunged down towards the earth, carrying the bowl of fire. This fire was so hot that she could not even touch it with her bare hands. The fire was contained within a bowl made of very, very precious stones and melts. Now, what happens? The river plunges deep into the earth and she hands down the fire to the rishis and munis waiting by the path. Now the fire was so hot that her hands burnt completely, and these patches of skin came out of her hands. And she continued towards her path and plunged into the sea to cool down herself.
Hello, I'm Gaur, and I have one more story to share with you. Once a sage offered a present to Lord Brahma, the god of creation. But he did not like it because the gifts were too inferior as compared to him. Hearing this, the sage got so angry and decided to take revenge. And he used Saraswati as a tool for doing so.
Hello, I'm Priyanji. And then the sage went to Lord Saraswati and fed on her lies. And he said that Lord Brahma has said that you are not capable of becoming a goddess. And then Lord Saraswati got so angry.
Hello, I'm Unnai. Saraswati sucked off all the water sources on the earth. She sucked off all the water sources on the earth that could cause an apocalypse and went underground. Somehow, Vishnu convinced her to provide water to the earth, otherwise the world would end. Although she agreed to provide water to the earth, legend says she still remains underground.
Hi, my name is Khushi and I would like to add on something. Legend has said that the beautiful goddess Saraswati sprung from the forehead of her father Brahma, the god of creation, and Brahma was totally enchanted by the beauty.
Hello, my name is Ida. Unhappy with her modest intentions, he tried to bestow upon her, and even she tried to hide. And this is the reason why the river Saraswati flows under. and she made and the brief appearance she made above the ground is the legend's assert. And she even tried to hide and upon her tiring breath.
Hi, my name is Kathy, and in the past years there have been heated debates about the existence of River Saraswati. Now, the Indian mythology records several legends and anecdotes about the river's existence, and we also know that the river has gone underground, which is also recorded in few of the legends. Now we. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Rishika. Those who kept this mysterious river alive in their imaginations found a role when scientists mapped the course of an enormous dried up river beneath the Thar Desert. This 3500 year old paleo channel is believed to be the mythical Saraswati River. Since the late 19th century, scholars have suspected that the Vedic Saraswati River is the Ghaggar-Hakra system which flows through northwestern India and eastern Pakistan.
Hello everyone, I'm Prajna and I'm going to add up something to the existence of River Saraswati whose remains were founded by the scientists in Indus Valley Civilization, some parts of Punjab and even in the Thar Desert in India. Also, Michael Witzel, as we all know, a very famous scientist, has proposed that Milky Way, the heavenly afterlife, is superimposed on the River Saraswati. Also, ancient texts, importantly, there are epic Mahabharata has mentioned the remains of River Saraswati found.
Hello everyone, I'm Tulip. So the main reasons contributing to the drying of the Saraswati River appear to be the loss of its important tributaries due to the changes in river course and climate, like long drought periods and water seepage through earth faults and fissures. Also, the obstruction may have had happened because of the shifting of sand due to high winds. Also, now the whole northwest India up to the run of Kutch, which is a place near the Thar Desert, was subject to regular earthquakes, which resulted in the raising of land. Thank you.
Jenny, are your students comfortable? Should we go ahead or you would like to add something in between?
So do you still have something? You want to talk about
it? One or two speakers more? Are they comfortable?
Yes.
Who else? Samudra Mantar?
Hello friends, I'm Afia and the story I have to share is Samudra Mantar. Once Indra, the king of heaven, while riding on his elephant Airavat, came across sage Durvasa, who offered him a garland which was given to him by Lord Shiva. Indra accepted the gift and placed it on the trunk of its elephant as a test to prove that he was not an egoistic deva. The elephant, knowing that Indra had no control over his own ego, threw the garland on the ground. This enraged the sage and Indra cursed all the devas, including Indra, to be bereft of all their power, fortune and strength.
Hello. In the battle between the devas and the Asuras won the battle from the devas and gained control over the whole universe. The devas went to Vishnu to seek help, and Vishnu advised to treat the Asuras in a diplomatic manner and jointly churn the ocean to gain the nectar of immortality. Samudra Manthan. Samudra means ocean and Manthan is to churn the ocean. This is churning the ocean. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Navishka. The churning of the ocean was an elaborate process in which Mount Madhura was used as a churning rod, whereas snake Vasuki, which abides in the neck of Lord Shiva, was used as a churning rope. But when Mount Madhura was placed on the ocean, it started to sink. Seeing this, Lord Vishnu turned himself into a tortoise. This avatar of him is known as Kurma, by which he supported the mountain by the shell. After the mountain was balanced, the demons and the gods tried to pull the snake Vasuki on either sides. When the turning began, an extremely poisonous drink called Halahal was produced. Seeing this, the gods got scared as it could destroy their creations.
Hello everyone, I'm Harshita and I'll continue the legend from here. Now all the gods turned to Lord Shiv for help and he immediately gulped down the entire Halahal. But he did not drink it completely. He stored it in his throat, because of which his throat turned blue in color. From that day onwards, Lord Shiv is also referred to as Neel for blue and Kant for neck.
Hello everyone, I'm Shraddha and I'll be continuing the legend. Meanwhile, Lord Vishnu had another plan for distributing the nectar among the gods and the poison among the demons. So he transformed himself into a beautiful dancer, Mohini, and started dancing around the gathering of the gods and the demons. He then poured down the nectar and the poison into separate glasses and started distributing it amongst the gods and the demons. He secretly gave the nectar to the gods and the poison to the demons.
Meanwhile, Mohini started distributing poison among the asuras. Some of the demons got hint of this action and they decided to secretly steal the amrit from the gods and consume it. Two of the demons, Rahu and Ketu, got their heads cut off by Lord Vishnu while in the process of drinking the amrit. These heads, till date, are immortal and are known as Rahu and Ketu.
After the heads of Kahukeda were cut off by Lord Vishnu, Vishnu acquired his true form and decided to flee with the pot of Amrit on the giant eagle Garuda. While fleeing away, four drops of Amrit fell on four spots on India. These four spots are known as the purest spots on India, namely Haridwar, Nasik, Ujjain, and Allahabad.
Jenny, I would like your students to share something in case they want to share with us.
Okay, yes.
They're all excited, I think. They're all excited.
Hi, my name is S. I'm 11 years old and I'm a child of the church. Finland is very complete. It is very cold as well. Then I'm from Kali. To everyone in the world, it's here. This is the Nila.
Hi, my name is Kali and I'm 11 years old. I think I have is not because we are sending to my head for this kind of time of work and our very fast. Hello, my name is Elena. I am 11 years old from Iran. My feet are dance, I cook and bake. My favorite color is purple and purple is Finland. Finland is a small country. Finland's capital is Helsinki. Finland summer is warm and rainy and winter is cold and snow. Varkaus is my hometown. Varkaus is fun and beautiful.
Hi, my name is Neil. I'm 11 years old. My hobbies are Europe and France. Finland's capital is Helsinki. Finland is Berlin. A reindeer in Finland. There are transport trees.
Is that okay? Yes.
Sound?
Yes, the sound is okay.
My name is Aya, I'm very just of your talk. I will tell something about Finland. In Finland, we are famous in the summer, spring, winter, and fall. In winter, snow is gross. Finland's made of cheese of pink.
Okay.
Very nice.
Okay.
and very nicely they had given their introduction. But any one of them can name a few rivers of Finland?
No, I don't have that subject.
Okay. So they have not studied about the rivers of Finland. Do we have rivers in Finland otherwise?
Yes, we have a lot of rivers and lakes.
Okay, great, great. So anyone, any of your students, if you can ask that they have already made a visit to any of the lakes and rivers and they know something about it.
Actually, our hometown Sichuan is like many lakes.
Okay.
So if you Google it, Lake Taima.
Wonderful, wonderful. And I've heard that Finland, basically we don't have suns for around 9 months there.
Yes, in the northern part.
Okay, so you have a brighter side here. I can see
that. Yes, we have.
So that's lovely to see the sunny side and all lovely and cheerful faces.
Yeah.
Okay, that was a nice session long ago. I think all 11-year students here, they all introduce themselves as 11-year-old.
Some are 12.
Okay, 12 also. Who are there who are sitting as 12-year-old? Can you raise your hand, girls or boys here? Oh, wow.
And which only me.
Okay, great. And our girls are basically, how many years old you have turned?
13.
So they're all 13 here. So,
okay.
And which grade do they follow there?
It's 5th grade.
Okay. So the 6th year and we have 9th year.
So you're on 9?
Yes, they're all 9. So they've just been upgraded to class 9th. Earlier, just 1 month back, they were in class 8.
Okay.
And when are they going to the next level now?
In the fall, August.
August, okay, okay.
Yeah.
So that's a wonderful thing. And I hope that next time we have another beautiful session with all the lovely faces around and more participants here, and they would talk about their rivers or something else that you have to come up with. Any other activity that you would like to share with us?
Yeah.
And a very, very big thank you from all our girls.
Thank you.
Thank you also.
Very soon we'll be sharing another activity with you.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
Okay, I mean just another month to go, we would like to share another activity with you.
Okay.
So we'll just have the sharing on the e-pals again, and I think Nishtha is here, so she would be helping you out with this.
Yeah, okay.
Right, and just share the pictures. We can have more pictures from your side if something has been stored right now, and I'll be sending it across from my side too.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay, yeah, bye.